This next round of evening is brought to you by We Let We Sell, and takes place over three rounds in the Your Bantamweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, representing Sekioku, and bringing into the cage a record of one win and two defeats, presenting Chris Knobs! Fighting out of the red corner, representing SBG Charlestown, bringing into the cage a record of one win and one defeat. Please welcome Morgan Hines.
My lover's got my money, he's got his strong beliefs. My lover's got my power, he's got his strong beliefs. My lover's got my faith, he's got his strong beliefs. My lover's got my money, he's got his strong beliefs. One more and more, people just want more and more, freedom and love. What is looking for? One more and more, people just want more and more, freedom and love.
Fight number six here. Chris Knobs versus Morgan Hines. Morgan Hines attempting a pass here. Has the knees pinched quite well, Paul?
Definitely, yeah. He's making it very, very difficult for Chris Knobs to start this first round. Listening to Coach Owen Roddy there, asked him to turn his opponent away from the fence, manages to do so.
Passes on now. Be looking for a knee cut here with my right leg instead of trying to weave it over the butterfly hook, but he's still in a good chest-to-chest position here. He's following Owen Roddy's instructions to an absolute T in terms of the control.
He has a good patient start here. Kind of a modified lockdown position that his opponent has from the bottom here, but he's struggling to maintain it.
Well, the lockdown is another thing entirely. I'd nearly feel like I'd need to apologize to the catch wrestlers and just make fun of the 10th Planet practitioners instead.
I'm a big fan of the lockdown myself.
Are you, Paul?
Yeah,
good huge stall in position.
Yeah. Makes the big lads regret trying to smash you with their chest.
He's got the pass to the mount. Bridge and roll was just not enough.
Yeah, really calm, precise top pressure by Morgan Hines. Toyed with the idea of an Americana.
Gone for the gift wrap instead. He's going to maybe think... Oh.
The gift wrap, a great old school position for mixed martial arts to land damaging blows.
Now he has it.
I was calling a fight the other evening, Andrew, and if the fella tore the other guy's shoulder with an Americana.
Really?
Yeah, it was awful. It was one of those that was on for a good minute.
You were away, were you? You haven't mentioned it yet.
I was in sunnier climates.
I'm Paul Brown. I was in Brazil. Here we are. This is going to be draining for Chris Knox on the bottom because his bridge and roll attempts have been getting close.
Yeah, he's putting a lot of energy into them and getting nowhere.
Armbar.
Swinging for that armbar. He just didn't get the leg over the head, although he might do now. The Oma Plata. He's coming up at a scramble there. Good work by Knox just to get his arm out of that Oma Plata attempt.
So while there may well have been other documented video evidence of it, it may have happened elsewhere, but one for the trivia books here, Paul. First recorded Oma Plata in MMA history.
I do remember Ben Saunders getting one in the UFC. Was there one before that?
Joey Breslin.
Ah, Joey.
Joey Breslin in his, I believe, his one and only amateur MMA fight.
He only ever had one fight, didn't he? Bonus points if you can name the opponent.
I can't, but I know Barry Oglesby was the promoter.
Ah, the fight before Christmas, was it?
It may well have been, yeah. But he is after making a great decision. Morgan Hines, if you remember Gunnar Nelson, when he got that armbar in the last 10 seconds. Armbar from mount, not necessarily something that you should consider going for, but in the last 10 seconds of a round,
why not?
Yeah. You know, because it's there. So a lovely transition from the armbar attempt into an Oma Plata.
Yeah, I'm very impressed with the grappling of Morgan Hines.
Yeah, we've seen terror control there. I'd like to see if he gets that gift wrap again, to think about a chair sit towards the back, and if the mount is not an option any further.
Hines, a 1-1 record. He won his debut by armbar in 2022. Lost the decision last April in his second fight. Both of those took place in England. So this is his first time fighting in Ireland. He's fought in Liverpool and Manchester before.
That's a strong right hand from Knox that sent his head snapping back. He seems a lot more comfortable on the feet here.
Knox, all three of his fights took place in 2017 and 2018. His last bout was a loss to Rory Lavery in March 2018.
There you go.
So he's been around a while, just hasn't been competing over the last kind of four
butterfly
or five years.
Butterfly hook should be used here with the left foot, but Morgan was able to swallow that left leg before it was a viable option.
See how he just limits the movement of Knox on the bottom. Smothering pressure.
Unruly's on the right buzz here in the corner, asking for the tripod passing. Jiu-jitsu appreciators would be able to go and watch Joseph Chen's tripod passing from the ADCC trials. He's an absolute phenom who won the trials. Probably the hardest bracket in the ADCC qualification history, but by keeping your head high, head on the mat, underhooks high, you can afford for your feet to be a little bit looser here.
Yeah.
Because it's not, if your head is in the right position and you're given enough pressure, you're not going to be swept. You're not going to be bridged and rolled from these positions. There is a perfect example of it. You give the opponent the illusion of them thinking that they have a chance at the bridge and roll, and it's demoralizing.
Yeah, it's a technique I'm very familiar with now. It's the great Stephen O'Toole showed me that many years ago.
See this underhook? I wouldn't give it up for the world. This right hand underhook.
Yeah.
Walk it and isolate up.
He's actually trying to swim it back inside now. And over we go. The armbar is on this time, Andrew. He got the leg across the face this time. Extends the arm. It's on and it's a tap. And Morgan Hines gets his second armbar victory and moves to 2-1.
That was an amazing a transition from Morgan, because we thought, what are you at, swimming that hand in?
Yeah.
And he actually...
He did get swept.
He got bridged and swept because of from Chris Knox. But great awareness from Morgan when he's put in that position to realise that he could transition to an armbar.
Yeah, and contrary to what happened at the end of the first round, he got his leg over the face immediately that time.
And he got it in time. No need for the omoplata attempt there. Paul Brown is making a strut. He's strutting today. This man is on cloud nine, ladies and gentlemen. Just off a lovely trip to Brazil. Still not anywhere tanned. In fairness to him, he got in this morning. He came straight to Nuri. He's an absolute legend.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes after 2 minutes and 10 seconds of the second round. Your winner by submission due to an armbar, Morgan!